Well, hey guys, welcome back to another episode of 0 to 60. And this is a video I was hoping I wasn't going to be making quite this soon, but there is definitely something seriously wrong with my motor. To give you a background, so this is filmed one day after the diff video that you would have seen. There were no problems with the car yesterday at all. In fact, I've got a clip of it idling yesterday, so you can hear it right now. And yeah, so today got up, looking forward to taking it for a bit of a drive. To be fair, I was only just going into town, but I just wanted to get some more miles up on that diff. Went into town, got my hair cut. It was basically a 15-ish minute drive out to where I got my hair cut. I cruised out there. The car was obviously cold, so it wouldn't have gone over 2,500 RPM. There was no boosting at all. Got my hair cut, got back in the car and started driving back. The car's got some temperature in it now. Actually, it was just as we were coming back onto the highway, so the car's definitely up to temp, and I accelerated onto the highway and wound out third a little bit. Now, it wasn't like a wide open throttle acceleration, so I couldn't tell you if it is definitely down on power, but the car made a different sound. It didn't sound like it normally does. It was a much deeper noise. I thought, oh, that's a bit weird. As soon as I heard that it was revving or making a different noise, I backed off. Anyway, I cruised back, and to be fair, it sort of drives fine once the revs are up over about 1,000 RPM. Like, you can't really tell it's any different, but as soon as I pull back in here, I could hear it, and I guess I need to show you guys to see what you think. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put this microphone just here near the exhausts. So hopefully that'll pick up the exhaust nicely. And yeah, so basically it's got a rough idle, or it's a misfire in my opinion. Yeah, the needle's not really moving much. Like, it looks steady, but hopefully you can hear that rear sound's not normal. Now, I'll bring it up off of idle. Like, it revs pretty smooth. I'll just move that microphone because it might be pretty loud. Yeah, so it revs pretty smoothly, but it is not running properly. A bit of vapor coming out there, which I think I've seen before. I don't normally open the oil cap very often. Let me know if that's normal. Now, I did let the car cool down a bit, and normally the coolant tank will stay pressurized for quite some time, but yeah, I reckon after it was parked for maybe 20 minutes I could actually crack the coolant tank. Now, to me, that sounds like, actually, let me shut this down. I'll get in the car so it's a bit quieter and you can hear me properly. Shut it off. Yeah, to me, that sounds like a cylinder's down. Or a cylinder's still firing, but it's not firing properly. I have, as soon as I got back, I scanned the car with the JB4. No fault codes, well, except for power management, but that's a normal code that we'll see. No real codes at all. Yeah, it's a bit of a weird one. Like, I imagine if it was an injector issue, other than a leaking injector, but this car has got index 12 injectors, I'd imagine if it was an injector issue or a ignition issue, we should get a fault code. I'm thinking it's something a bit more serious and there's something wrong with one of the cylinders. I wasn't going to drive it again, but just so that you guys can see this behavior, if anybody else is ever trying to diagnose this down the track. Hopefully you can hear in the mic, like, it sounds normal. And then, I mean, it's almost like the car has a cam, which would be kind of cool, but it does not have a cam. Something has happened to it. And I might not have noticed it this morning because I was running a bit late and I did sort of jump in the car and just idled out like we are now. And as soon as you're up around 1,000 RPM, you can't really hear any issues with the engine. Like it's... Yeah, it's... we'll just go to the end of the street and back. Oh, diff is grabbing. Oh, I'm so shitty. I was looking forward to actually driving it a bit more since it's been parked up for really 2 weeks. As soon as I'm off the accelerator, I can hear it doesn't sound normal. I'll accelerate. Here it comes up on the boost. Yeah, like it feels pretty normal, but it definitely doesn't sound right. So hopefully somebody might know what this is. I really don't want it to be a gasket or cracked piston or a ringland or something like that, but I'm leaning towards it actually being something quite significant and mechanical. I don't think this is an electrical issue. Everyone I can find that's had like VANOS issues or ignition issues or fuel issues, it'll get a code. And actually I have done a JB4 log, so let's go and have a quick look at that log as well. Now I've just logged the idling to see. She still sounds wrong. Come have a listen. And we got mist coming out of the pipes. It's a fair bit of mist, isn't it? It was driven this morning. That's not oil smoke. Like it's just smells like fuel vapor. If the GoPro is picking that up, hopefully it is. What do you think it is? It's not firing properly. I'll grab the key. Now I did do a data log just before, and again, sorry, my head's fried. I really hope I don't have to swap this engine. I did do a data log. Let's go inside and I'll show you guys all the things that are coming up when it's idling, because I think everything seems fine electronically. So hopefully you can see the data's app log just behind the camera. Long story short, this is the log I've got of the idle. Now you can see here, the RPMs do stutter a little bit. We're getting very slight, that's a normal idle, but we're hovering around 700 RPM. And just here, I start revving the car just to sort of see if it triggers anything in the log to sort of identify what might be causing this rough idle. So this pink line up here is the fuel high pressure. I was wondering if there's an issue with the high pressure fuel pump. Sorry, the pink line is the low pressure, but again, it's pretty solid. The bottom line is the high pressure fuel pump, and it's doing exactly what it should be doing. I'll turn those two off. All of the ignitions or cylinder ignition timing, that's all pretty normal until you can see here, this is when I started touching the throttle and it pulls up. So ignition's doing what it should be doing. I'll just show you guys quickly the AFRs. AFR1, AFR2, like they're moving pretty much together. This is idle conditions as well, and we'll get a bit of fluctuations once it starts revving. But they are like between, there's a little bit of a difference there, like 14.7 to 13.9. But to me, they're moving pretty well together, and I'll show you trims as well quickly. There we have trims, and they're not, they're pretty much bang on. It's not doing anything out of the normal to make it idle funny. Now, when I do actually rev it, I'm not sure if the camera's gonna pick it up, but that stutter or hesitation or uneven sound does go with the revs. So it doesn't fix the misfire as the RPMs come up. It seems to go all the way through, and it's like, I tried to describe it earlier. I really feel it's like it's just doing, one of the cylinders is getting like 80% of its explosion that it should be getting. I hope that makes sense.
a little bit bummed out. Yeah, there's not really much else to check. Everything in the log looks as it should. I'll put a link to this log in the description if you guys do want to check it out yourself. But yeah, please let me know what you think it might be. Yeah, I guess from this point I need to do either a leak down test or a head gasket test and check the spark plugs and go from there. But I wanted your ideas before I started stripping it down. if it is worst case scenario, it is an engine. It's not the end of the world. It just means a bit more downtime if I get to drive the bloody thing again. My concerns about the health of this engine is the only reason I bought the parts car. If you've been following along, like that first time I ran 27 PSI, I was genuinely worried that it was just going to blow it to pieces because I don't know how the previous owners looked after this motor. I suspect they didn't service it ever. But yeah, all right guys, sorry it's a bit of a downer video, but it's one of those ones that you've got to... I've got to live with, I guess. Yeah, look, would love any ideas on what it might be. And I'll might do a compression test tonight. We'll see how we go. All right, guys. Thank you very much for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.